JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for December the 29th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against all but two of the other major currencies on Tuesday during the Asian session Wednesday. The currencies against which it failed to get out any gains were the yen and the Swiss franc, with dollar yen and dollar franc found virtually unchanged this morning. The greenback strengthened the most versus NZD, CAD, AUD and the euro. The strengthening of the US dollar and the other safe havens, yen and franc, combined with the weakening of the risk-linked currencies Kiwi, Luni and Aussie, suggests that markets may have turned to risk-off at some point yesterday. Indeed, we see that major EU indices traded in the green, but the picture turned more mixed during the US session and deteriorated even further today in Asia. Now, with a very light economic agenda, thin liquidity, and no straightforward headlines to support the switch in appetite, it is hard to identify the real driver. It could be the surging COVID cases around the globe, or maybe investors are closing their books for the year. In any case, yesterday's pullback is far from suggesting a trend reversal, with media suggesting that the fast spreading of the Omicron COVID variant is unlikely to lead to global lockdowns again due to its milder symptoms, investors may decide to reignite the so-called standard rally for the remaining of the week. However, we repeat once again that we are reluctant to call for a long-lasting recovery. Although the prospect of a full-scale global lockdown may be off the table for now, several nations may be waiting to tighten existing restrictions after the holiday season. So with also most major central banks being in the process of removing stimulus due to extremely high inflation and not willing to resume rescue programs to treat any potential economic wounds that may result in due to additional restrictions, we cannot rule out some decent setbacks in the markets after the turn of the year. Now, as for today's events, the only releases worth mentioning on today's schedule are the US pending home sales for November and the Energy Information Administration report on crude oil inventories for last week. Pending home sales are expected to have slowed notably to 0.5% month over month from 7.5%, while the Energy Information Administration report is forecast to show that inventories have slid by 3.233 million barrels after falling by 4.715 millions the week before. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.